Bezat Hashem, welcome to Emunah Beams with your host Laser Brody. Today's episode number 33 is entitled The Valiant Leader, and it talks about the type of spiritual leadership we need in this difficult generation. Now, during the time of the Russian Revolution in 1917, there were terrible winds of heresy that were fighting against Judaism and the Jewish people and pulling young people away from Torah and mitzvot. So meanwhile, in one of Russia's small towns where the majority of the population was Jewish, the local rabbi died. He was a gentle and learned man of piety whom everybody loved. Well, a fierce argument broke out in the town after the Shiva, the seven-day mourning period. The elders of the town, they wanted to crown the rabbi's oldest son as the new rabbi, in line with the centuries-old tradition that the deceased rabbi's son is worthy, then he's the one that replaces the father. Well, the rabbi's son was certainly a pious Torah scholar like his father, and he had ordinations from the generation's leading rabbis, but he was also gentle and soft-spoken like his father. Well, the elders claimed he'd be perfect for the position, but the young people, they were bitterly opposed. Yeah, they respected the rabbi's son, but they claimed that he was out of reach with the challenges of the generation. Well, every single day, more and more young Jewish men were cutting off their beards and falling into the traps of the communists, the enlightenments, and the town's young people claimed that the rabbi's son wouldn't be able to fight any of this. And he couldn't stop the tide of atheism and emancipation because he didn't have the strength. He didn't have the spiritual and physical strength they needed to bring someone fierce and dynamic from the outside. A rabbi who would lead the town with a fearless, strong hand, and otherwise there would be no community left, but nothing but old people. The argument went on for weeks and weeks, and there was no solution. So finally, an objective outsider who came into town, he suggested, well, what are you guys arguing about? Go to the Chofetz Chaim in Raden and agree to whatever he decides. So they agreed, and they traveled to Raden. Well, the Chofetz Chaim listened with intent to each side, the young people and the older people, and the Chofetz Chaim carefully weighed each word of their respective arguments. When both sides finished speaking, he closed his eyes in deep concentration for about 3 or 4 minutes, and you could hear a pin drop in the room, and the tension was very high. Well, the Chofetz Chaim finally opened up his eyes and he began to speak, and the Chofetz Chaim said, there's a difference between the Kohen Gadol, which is the high priest, and the Meshuach Milchama, which is the anointed priest that leads the army in battle. The Torah teaches us, said the Chofetz Chaim, that when Aaron, the high priest, passed away, his son Elazar replaced him. Well, Elazar was certainly a worthy replacement, a holy scholar like his father, but Pinchas became the Meshuach Milchama, not because he was Elazar's son, because he proved himself in time of turmoil as a valiant spiritual leader who served Hashem with total dedication and zeal, and Pinchas wasn't afraid of anybody. So we see that the office of Kohen Gadol is hereditary, whereas the job of Meshuach Milchama, it's not. And the Chofetz Chaim took a deep breath, and he continued, and he said to the townspeople, he said, in the old days, before the cancer of the so-called Enlightenment began spreading across Eastern Europe, a town would choose the finest Torah scholar it could to become its rabbi and its spiritual leader. Yet today, things are different. There's a war raging against Emunah and a war raging against anything that's Jewish, both physical and moral and spiritual. So we need valiant leaders who could bravely stand up to our spiritual enemies and bring our young people back to the fold. Chofetz Chaim said, I therefore respectfully concur with the young people of the town. Search for a rabbi that will be fearful and valiant to fight the war of Torah and Emunah. That's the story. I heard that story from the Militzer Rebbe. And that story, more than ever, is true today. We need valiant spiritual leaders who are afraid of no one but Hashem. Quiet Torah scholars, they could be capable of being the high priest for sure, but they don't necessarily have the qualifications to lead us in battle. We need rabbis that aren't afraid to speak out, even if it means jolting the establishment, even these total political incorrectness. We need rabbis that they don't consider the political ramifications of what they say, We need rabbis that are brave enough to blow the whistle on such evil as child molestation, wife beaters, and social injustice, even if the offenders are the sons of rebbes and rosh yeshivas. We need rabbis that can take the heat. We need rabbis of impeccable character and unblemished personal ethics and holiness who can serve as spiritual leaders and role models for all of us. In short, with enemies all around us, we need a valiant Mashiach Milchoma to lead us in the final battle for the redemption of our people, speeding our days. Amen.